a treasure of honey in the cones of God, a treasure of honey. Now honey, that is the divine aspect of it. The cone, that is the physical. Madhurya, you see, that is honey, sweetness. Honey in the combs of God. You see, this is the physical nature, but it is the comb of God. The physical nature has to hold that honey in it. It has to hold that honey in it, you see. It is the comb of God itself, you see. A treasure of honey, a splendor burning in the tenebrous globe. See, he is giving another example. Here is the treasure of honey in the combs of God, or a splendor in a tenebrous globe. Dark cloak, it has put on a dark cloak, but there is a splendor behind it, inside it, you see. So honey and comb, splendor and tenebrous cloak, it is the glory of the flame of God. It is the glory of the flame of God, that self, that soul, it is the glory. In other words, what a wonderful thing has happened. That soul has come here, and it is because of that these things can proceed, can materialize, can take shape here. In our glory with the flame of God, our golden fountain of the world's delight, our golden fountain of the world's delight, what a line, our golden fountain of the world's delight. It will be very beautiful. And see the alliteration, golden fountain of the world's delight. Our golden, that is one. Our golden, that is I am. Then fountain, I am. Brick, the world, again I am. Delight, again and I am. So you have got here, I am, brick, I am. That is the scansion of the line, you see. Our golden fountain of the world's delight. What a wonderful, promising line, you see. Yes, it is that our golden fountain. We can dry all our joy. We can drink water from that fountain in plenty, ceaselessly. It does not get dry at all, you see. It never ceases to run, you see. Our golden fountain of the world's delight. So we can live this world with that joy, you see. And immortality, cows in the cave of death. I'll give another example of that thing. The shape of our unborn divinity. All that thing is for what? That the divinity which is there, it should take birth. All that thing is for the divinity to take birth. The shape of our unborn divinity, the whole urge, the whole push, the whole drive is for the divinization of things here. All that you. So when the inner lamps are lit, etc., all these things happen, then you are really moving towards this unborn divinity taking shape within us. He is coming and residing within us. It guards for us our fate in depth within. So it is not really just a fate, it is something which is very positive. The prospects are locked in it and it will happen. Where sleeps the eternal seed of transient thing? Where sleeps the eternal seed of transient thing? Where sleeps the eternal seed of transient things? Seed of transient things. Yeah. In other words, although things are transient, there is a seed here or something very high, something very superior, something very everlasting. Where sleep, it is lying there. The sleep is in the dormant state, you see. The moment it finds proper soil, proper conditions to grow and all that thing, it will sprout, spring up and flower also, you see. Where sleep, the eternal seed of transient thing. In words, it is our soul, this path of the divine, that Agni, that small little Vishnu who is there within us. It is he who has become the cause of transient things for a certain purpose. He has become the cause of transient things because of them. See, I am calling that little spark, the self or the soul, or that little Vishnu who is there within us. You see, Agni, Vishnu, actually in the largest sense, Agni is a form of Vishnu. Agni is a form of Vishnu. When that Agni is present within us, small little spark, that psychic being, it is a little Vishnu who is really present in us. It is that little Vishnu who is present within us, you see. And that is very appropriate also. See, it is the divine who has come and accepted this condition in us. In other words, that fire, that Agni, that Vishnu, he is the little avatar who is present within us. He is in fact the little avatar himself who is present within us. We are not aware of that little avatar. We don't go by it, what is saying. So in fact, we are already having that avatar, or small little Vishnu, that avatar is already present in us. That fire, that Agni is that avatar in us. Agni means the divine himself who has come and stayed in this creation here. That is the avatar. And doing work. Avatar does not come just for nothing. He comes and does work. He is a traveler. He takes you forward on the journey towards God, towards all this realization. See. So he is there present in us. May I sleep the eternal seed. It is because of him that these transient things are possible. They have become like that, you see. It guards for us our fate in depths within. May I sleep the eternal seed of transient things. Always we bear in us a magic key. Yeah, well, we have got problems, we have got difficulties, but there is a solution also. There is a key. You see that the doors are locked, but there is a key also. That little self is a magic key. That soul is a magic key. That little Vishnu, that little fire, he is a magic key. You be in company with him. Make friendship with him and he will take you properly. That is his magic key. He will open the doors for you wherever you want to go then, you see. That little Vishnu, that little avatar which is there within us. In fact, that little avatar is there in everybody. We are not aware of it. Conceived in light, hermetic envelope. It is airtight, absolutely foolproof. Nothing can enter into it. Hermetic envelope. What is the hermetic? You have got the physical nature, you have got the vital nature, you have got outer nature, inner nature, all those things are there. Behind that, it is conceived. Or in other words, that little magic key, that little Vishnu is housed deep within us. And there are layers and layers which are kind of covering it. The inner being, the outer being, the surface being, all the things are covering like that, you see. Conceived in life's hermetic envelope. A burning witness in the sanctuary is also a witness. Sakshi, it is he who observes all these things. He notices everything what is happening. A burning witness in the sanctuary, regarding the time, the blind walls of form. He is seeing everything. Regarding means seeing, observing. Regarding the time, the blind walls of form. A timeless light is in his hidden eye. Yeah, obviously that Vishnu is Vishnu. So his eye, although we are not same thing, what he'll carry? He'll carry that timeless light always. That Divya Agni, that golden fire which is there within us, it has that light. He sees the secret thing no words can speak. Obviously, in our utterances, our faculties fail to describe what it can achieve. He sees the secret thing no words can speak, and know the goal or the unconscious world. Yes, he is there. He knows what is all this for. This slow march, long march, exercise for what? So that the divine manifestation is there. That the apocalypse does occur here. For that he knows it. He has that vision. In fact, he comes for that purpose only. He accepts this mortal condition of ignorance, of inconscience. So that out of it, that divinity might flower up. And heart of mystery, of the journey here. and the heart, the mystery, the journey, and still again, and the heart, anapes, of the mystery, anapes. Mystery, anapes. Of the journey, again, anapes. So you got four anapes here in this line. And the heart of the mystery of the journey here. Four anapes, 1, 3, you see. Very unusual line, very long line also, you see. And the heart of the mystery of the journey here. Poetically, it's a wonderful line. And the heart of the mystery of the journey here. See, it kind of goes on spreading, you see. Expanding, moves on. And the heart into the mystery of the journey, you see. The travel, the journey continues, you see. Yes, these are the glories, timeless regard, hidden. The soul is waiting for the apocalypse. Yes, these are the things which the soul is seeing it. But what is there in the meanwhile? What does it see? But all is green, subliminal, mystical. We are not aware of it. Subliminal, beyond our reach, beyond our door. Actually, one might say, although subliminal is the common word, but Sri Aurobindo also sometimes use a supraliminal. Above the threshold. Supraliminal threshold. Above the threshold. All is green, supraliminal, mystical. It needs the intuitive heart, the inward turn. It needs the power of a spiritual gaze. What is that it? All that is seen here, that apocalypse. You can't see ordinarily. It needs an intuition. The heart has an intuition. The heart should immediately perceive it. It needs an inward turn. Not by outward projection, can you see it here? By analytical faculties, mental faculties, but something which goes deep within. It needs the intuitive heart. See, this is an important thing. The heart has its own intuition. The heart knows that tomorrow there will be the divine glory here. Heart may be suffering, may be experiencing pain, difficulty. There might be palpitation or not, you see. But heart knows within, yes, all that thing is for something which is going to happen tomorrow. The apocalypse, the divine manifestation, divine throb will be there within us. The inward turn, it needs the power of a spiritual gaze. So there are two faculties, heart and spiritual gaze. The inner, heart stands for the inner. Spiritual stands for the higher. Inverse, you need this subliminal, criminal, subliminal, the mystical screen, etc., etc., can open out if there is the intuition of the heart. Can open out if there is spiritual gaze. Now, spiritual gaze stands for something above. Heart stands something from within. In other words, the subliminal screen, mystical, can be accessible to both the occult faculties, the inner belonging to the heart, or the higher, the spiritual belonging to above head. So in one sentence, he has said both. You need the intuitive heart, the inner faculties, as well as you need the spiritual faculties above. In other words, the intuitive heart corresponds to the occult process. The spiritual gaze corresponds to the Vedantic process. This is the tantric, intuitive heart, the tantric. Spiritual gaze corresponds to the Vedantic. It needs the intuitive heart, the spiritual gaze. All that we have seen so far, all that is screened, is covered up. But that can be accessed if the heart has intuition, if the inner faculties have developed to gain the spiritual, or there is a spiritual gaze above.